SpaceX finally completed the wet dress rehearsal of Flight 7 Starship Super Heavy. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Many of you have been eager for a full update on upcoming SpaceX's Starship Super Heavy Flight 7. We haven't covered this in a while, but here's the latest. SpaceX has successfully completed the Wet Dress Rehearsal WDR for the 7th flight test. In this episode, we'll dive deep into what to expect from SpaceX's Starship Flight 7. On January 9th, 2025, SpaceX introduced the Starship Block 2, specifically Ship 33, to the Starbase launch site for the first time. This milestone marks a significant step toward the upcoming Flight 7, which is currently scheduled for no earlier than January 13th, 2025, with a launch window opening at 11 p.m. Eastern Time. The preparation included a crucial wet dress rehearsal yesterday, January 10th, where SpaceX simulated every aspect of the launch process, stopping just short of ignition. This rehearsal was conducted with both Booster 14 and Ship 33, fully fueled with liquid methane and oxygen, mimicking the conditions they would face on launch day. This comprehensive simulation not only tests the readiness of the launch infrastructure, but also the performance of the spacecraft under full load conditions. The Starship Block 2 represents a significant upgrade over its predecessors. With expanded tanks, the total propellant capacity has increased to 4,900 tons from the previous 4,500 tons, enhancing the rocket's performance and endurance. This increase in propellant capacity is pivotal for SpaceX's ambitions, including interplanetary travel and satellite deployment. The combined height of Booster 14 and Ship 33 stands at 123 meters, making this the tallest Starship configuration to date, thanks to an additional stainless steel ring that adds roughly 2 meters to the structure. This not only enhances its aesthetic, but also its functional capabilities, particularly in terms of payload and operational range. The 7th flight of Starship is laden with critical objectives that are stepping stones for SpaceX's broader space exploration goals. One of the primary tasks is to test the structural integrity and operational enhancements of the Block 2 design. This includes testing the new positioning of upper wings and the robustness of the updated heat shield, both of which were partially tested in previous flights. The heat shield's performance is crucial for protecting the spacecraft during the intense heat of atmospheric re-entry. Additionally, Flight 7 will see the deployment of 10 mock Starlink, version 3 satellites. These are not functional satellites, but are designed to mimic the size and mass of the real ones to test the loading and release mechanisms. This test follows a suborbital trajectory, meaning the mock satellites will not enter into orbit, but will instead re-enter and disintegrate in the atmosphere shortly after release, providing valuable data on the deployment process. Ship 33 also features pins with thermal protection, which are set for future flight capture tests. Although these pins serve no structural purpose on this flight, they will help SpaceX assess damage from atmospheric re-entry, laying groundwork for future missions where Starship could be caught in mid-air by the launch tower's chopstick arms. Elon Musk has indicated that the first such in-flight capture might occur during the 8th launch, depending on the outcomes of Flight 7. SpaceX is keen on perfecting the in-orbit refueling technique, which is essential for long-duration missions like those planned for Mars. The success of Flight 7 will be instrumental in moving closer to that goal by testing key technologies under real flight conditions. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. You know, we're on a mission to reach 65,000 subscribers by next week. Join us on this journey and let's see if we can make it happen together. Safety remains paramount, especially with the ambitious goal of recovering both stages of the rocket. The Super Heavy booster is set to return to Earth for a potential catch by the chopstick arms at Starbase if all conditions are met. This operation is not only about recovery, but also about proving the reusability of the rocket system, which is central to SpaceX's economic model for space travel. If the conditions for a catch aren't safely met, the booster will perform a controlled splashdown in the Gulf of Mexico, as was done during the Flight 6 test. SpaceX has made it clear that they will only proceed with the Super Heavy catch if both the rocket and the launch tower meet stringent safety criteria. The company emphasizes no compromises on public and team safety, which will dictate the execution of the recovery plan. Starship Flight 7 will not only launch a new generation ship with significant upgrades, but will also attempt Starship's first payload deployment test, fly multiple re-entry experiments geared towards ship catch and reuse, and manage the launch and return of the Super Heavy booster, SpaceX detailed in their mission overview. The flight is more than just a test. It's a demonstration of SpaceX's evolving capabilities in space technology, setting the stage for future missions that could redefine space travel. The success of these experiments will directly influence SpaceX's plans for 2025, aiming to execute the first propellant transfer between two starships in space, a crucial step for deep space missions. Each test, each flight, builds upon the last, pushing the boundaries of what's possible in space engineering and exploration. In conclusion, as SpaceX stands at the tip of launching Starship Flight 7, the outcomes of this test will not only shape the near-term future of Starship's development, but could also accelerate our collective journey into space, making the dream of human settlements on other planets seem ever more tangible. The launch, if everything proceeds as planned, will be a spectacle of human ingenuity, a testament to the relentless pursuit of knowledge beyond our blue planet. Today at 2:11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket lifted off from Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida, carrying 21 Starlink satellites into orbit, 13 of which are equipped with direct-to-cell capabilities. This mission marked the 25th flight for this particular Falcon 9 first stage, establishing a new reuse record for SpaceX. 14 of these flights have been dedicated to deploying Starlink satellites, highlighting the company's commitment to expanding its satellite internet constellation. The first stage of the rocket successfully returned to Earth, landing on the drone ship. Just read the instructions in the Atlantic Ocean, approximately 8 minutes after launch, showcasing SpaceX's advancements in reusable rocket technology. Meanwhile, the upper stage of the Falcon 9 continued its journey to place the satellites into low Earth orbit, with deployment scheduled roughly 65 minutes post-liftoff. Starlink, now the largest satellite constellation in history, currently boasts over 6,870 operational satellites. This number includes about 400 satellites with direct-to-cell capabilities, according to Jonathan McDowell, an astrophysicist and satellite tracker. This constellation is pivotal for SpaceX's ambition to provide global broadband coverage, particularly in underserved and remote areas where traditional internet infrastructure is impractical or non-existent. The launch on January 10th was the fifth Falcon 9 mission of 2025, following a year where SpaceX achieved more than 130 launches, with roughly two-thirds being Starlink missions. This frequency of launches underscores SpaceX's aggressive schedule to populate the Starlink network further, aiming to enhance its services capacity, speed, and reliability. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.